I've been able to spend a week with the 2021 Kia Seltos, and I've got five things that I like and five things that I don't like coming right up. Now I want you to know I have a full review after spending a week with this with all the details on different trim levels if you want to see that, but let's get started. Now starting with my dislikes, in no particular order, it's going to be right up front here. So the main thing is that you can only get LED headlights on the top SXT trim. Otherwise you get these halogen projectors. The fog lights are not on the base model, but that's not a huge deal. You do get this LED daytime running light strip that runs all the way across the grille and kind of rejoins with that other side, but it would be nice to at least have the headlights optional, LED headlights optional, like some other Kias, but it's only on the top trim, and these halogens just don't do a very good job. Now, my dislike number two is not really a dislike, but it's something odd. The fact that all-wheel drive is actually standard on every trim except the S model. So if you want the Kia Seltos or a certain trim level in front-wheel drive, you can't get it unless you get the S model. So if you want a front-wheel drive Kia like this with similar features, you might need to go for the Kia Soul or the Kia Sportage or maybe even the Kia Niro if you just want front-wheel drive. And my third dislike is the fact that you don't get a regular automatic transmission. Now that's commonplace in vehicles of this price and this size. You get a variable transmission, which is mated pretty well to this regular engine right here. Or if you jump up in power, you get a dual clutch transmission. And I'm okay with the variable transmission for the economy on the less powerful engine, but with the more powerful engine, it would be nice to have a regular automatic transmission instead of the dual clutch. I've driven the 7-speed dual clutch in other Kia and Hyundai models, and they can be quick and responsive at times. They can also be really jerky and just not fun to drive with on a daily basis. So it'd be nice to have a regular stepped automatic transmission over a dual clutch. Now, dislike number four is that the smart cruise control, aka adaptive or radar cruise control, you can only get it on the top trim level with the turbo. So if you want it, you can't get it unless you go for the turbo. It'd be nice if it was optional at least. I know a lot of people comment in the comments below of videos on how much they like driving with that. Now, of course, you've got to drive the vehicle yourself. You've got to be paying attention, but at least it's nice to have that as an option. This does still have the lane following system. So I'm gonna go ahead and veer over, and it just jerks me right back to the middle to where it will guide you in your lanes, but no smart cruise on this trim. Now, my fifth dislike is, you can maybe tell on this road, and I'm not going as fast, we're only going like 40 to 45, but there's a fair amount of road noise that gets in here. Now, this class of vehicle is not supposed to be a whisper quiet vehicle, but compared to the others that I've tested on this road, at a different spot, same speed, same spot of the road, all the vehicles I test, this definitely tested louder. Now let me be honest, on the interstate, noise really isn't too bad. At high speeds you get some wind noise, but on a rougher surface you get quite a bit of that road noise, which can be a little annoying. And there's not much I don't like about this vehicle, it's just something I thought I'd mention. Now starting off with my likes, in no particular order, we're going to be under the hood right here. And I like the fact that you can get either a naturally aspirated 2-liter multi-port injected 4-cylinder engine, or you can get a 1.6-liter direct injected turbocharged engine. So you've got different flavors for different people. And of course, this regular 4-cylinder that we have in here, the naturally aspirated model, is going to be a little bit more efficient than that turbo, but it's nice that you at least have an option for either one. My third like is that it is very spacious for its size. So first of all, right behind here, you get 26 cubic feet. It swallows things up really well. 62 cubic feet when you fold the seats down, which is more than bigger vehicles in a larger class, like even the Kia Sportage, Mazda CX-5. So very impressive. And even rear seat legroom is very good for the exterior dimensions. So space is fantastic in here. Now my like number three comes under here, sort of, kind of the vehicle as a whole with the warranty. Like other Kias, Kia still gives you a 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. So if you're worried at all about anything with the powertrain, you're covered for 10 years or 100,000 miles. Plus, they have a 5-year, 60,000-mile basic warranty. So that covers bumper to bumper, and that's really awesome. You still have to do your maintenance, of course, but it's nice to know. Now, my fourth like is that the base LX trim is a great actual base trim. The S model is also a lower-end trim, but that LX is a low price, it's all-wheel drive standard, and you lose some of the little hassle features. There's no driver assist features for those of you that don't want any of those. It's missing some of the little things that you're not really going to care so much about. And the MSRP is around 23 grand after shipping, but it's still a good value with some of the things that you would expect and want in a vehicle without any extras. Now, my fifth like is the complete package that you get with the Seltos. It's not good at just one thing, it's good at a lot of things. It's just a great combination of a vehicle. It's got a lot of space, a lot of features, optional power as well, depending on what you want. And when you consider all of that, the space, the features, and the power, and I kind of talked about some of that earlier, but as a bundle for this class, it's very impressive. So those were just five likes and dislikes after spending a week with this 2021 Kia Seltos. What do you like or what do you not like? Leave your comments down below. And just remember, this is just after a week. This is subjective. But really, I enjoyed my time with the Kia Seltos, and I think it's a great offering for this size and this price of a vehicle. Be sure to check out the full review in the description below. Subscribe for weekly videos. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.